Never before in all our history have these forces been so united against one candidate as they stand today. They are unanimous in their hate for me, and I welcome their hatred.
The needs of working families, the middle class, not just the billionaire class. We know what's going on. We have paid attention.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. It's Saturday. It's Saturday. And the media wants to play again. It's Saturday. And in the last, not even 10 hours, 8 hours, I don't know how long it's been, I went to bed and the whole world was blowing up on the internet with what's going on in the White House. And it's not about Russia anymore than it was. It's really about the implosion of our government at the executive level. And you've got a lot of cards falling. House cards, yeah. The house of corruption is pretty much coming down. And it's interesting to see who is getting tossed under the bus, who's going to end up testifying, who's going to end up going to jail or whatnot. The cover is just a reminder of what happened to Nixon. Obstruction of justice forced him to resign. Right? He wasn't impeached, but the call for his impeachment, the investigation, this is what happened. And there's a lot of lawyers right now, a lot of people saying he's not going to last a year. Right? So I'm right there with him. Good morning, everybody. Just replace Nixon's head with Trump's. That's what that's going to be. Except I don't think he'll be putting his fingers in the air. He'll be going, he'll be smiling with his fit. Nah, I'm too big. And his excuse will be, my business adventures are too big and huge and terrific, and I really need to go take care of my businesses, and I'll leave America in the good hands of Pence because he's such a great guy. And then we'll be gone. It'll be, bye. And we'll see who they throw into the bus.
Except he won't do a peace sign as he goes out.
No, he won't.
He'll do if you saw the shot today.
He'll do the middle finger, guaranteed.
Oh, is that what you think he's going to do?
Yeah, doing the gunshot finger at reporters. Yeah.
I think he'll do his lame thumbs up.
So he'll do that. He'll do...
It'll be one of his silly things, most definitely. Where did I put you? Where are you at? You're over here on cam 4. Hang on, everybody. Got to fix there. There. All right. Good morning. We got Melissa and Springfield and Michael and Trisha and Grandma and Eco and Metalhead Cat and Melissa and Jupiter and just a lot of people. Good morning, everybody. Jeffrey Pearson and Alan Parker. And did you know that we have two Germans in the room? Two Germans in the room. We're going to talk to Dennis later. He's hanging out here. He's smiling. And it was hilarious earlier in the green room. We're sitting there talking. Both Markus and Dennis are like this with cigarettes. And they're talking German. And I was like, I could put that show with subtitles. Just somebody writing ridiculous subtitles. Two Germans talking, smoking cigarettes. And it would be a hit on YouTube, probably. Probably get more views than what we do now. Anyway, we're going to talk about healthcare systems because they've got an interesting perspective from Germany as well as Turkey, as well as America. So that's a lot of visiting. That's a lot of healthcare system knowledge. And they're both really glad that they're in Germany. I'll just tell you that right now. Who was? Wow, a lot of people. Good morning. Laura. Of course, Laura Live and Good is with us. You just saw her on screen. And So much to talk about. What I'm going to start off with is I'm going to read. Hey, Tony, how you doing? I'm going to read what Dan Rather wrote last night. These are Dan Rather's words because he sums it up pretty well for me. And it's kind of when you're buried in the holy shitness of what's going on, take a step back, breathe, and just look at the collapse of the American capitalist democracy. It's happening so much faster than anybody ever could have imagined. And it's glorious. It's wonderful.
It is kind of, isn't it?
It is.
In a Schadenfreude kind of way.
Yeah. It I know, what kind of way? Was that German? Did you just spew some German?
Yeah, that's taking this. Taking, it's a term. It means taking pleasure in another person's, you know.
What did you say? Schadenfucken? What did you, what was it?
Say it properly. Say it. Yeah, I was close.
Markus, say that. I could hear.
I didn't understand it. Dennis, did you understand?
Schadenfreude.
Schadenfreude.
Schadenfreude. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Holy crap. Everybody knows German except for me. I'm so embarrassed. Jesus.
And she described it perfectly.
Yeah.
Well, that's nice. Do you want to say hi? Everybody say hi to Dennis. There he is.
Yes.
Hey, there's Dennis. Dennis has some friends that are watching him, so let's not embarrass Dennis or say anything wrong about Dennis today. There's Dennis, everybody. Dennis on camera. You know what? Dennis has an infectious laugh, and he kind of reminds me of John Belushi. A young John Belushi before anyway, cool. But anyway, moving on. That wasn't the point. Hot Germans today on Awake With. No. I'm just trying to boost ratings, everybody.
We are slowly nearing the dick jokes again. I can sense it.
Yeah. It's Saturday, and we can do that. The Saturday show gets to have way more tech jokes.
I'm full for it, Aldo. Let's start.
What did you say? What? I'm just going to leave you on screen right now because I got to fix my mic. Thanks.
Okay.
You're a natural, Dennis. You're a YouTube star already. You're ready to go.
Yeah. Now you're a YouTube star.
German cam boys.
Go cam boys.
Nice one, Kat.
That's beautiful.
Thank you, Kat.
If it works for a Haley 420 or whatever she is, that can get a billion views by doing bong hits. And if you watched her, that poor girl, like, it looks like she coughs neurons out of her ears when she does these bong hits. Just blah, and brains are flying. She gets a million views.
I don't accept credit card. I only accept cash.
No credit. Bitcoin? Will you take Bitcoin?
PayPal. Sure, PayPal.
Right. Reality okay. TV. That's, all right. So listen, we got a lot of stuff to cover. I was working on this really serious part about Dan Rather and the things he had to say and what's going on. A collapse of democracy, not German camboys. Let's although better ratings, really. No. Okay. Serious. And we have a healthcare rally today, by the way. After this show, we're going to talk about healthcare because we have a healthcare rally coming up. It's at 1:30 Central. No. 3:30 Central, 1:30 Pacific. That's when we're starting with that. Scott Galindez is going to be there, and he's got the Live View Solo. We're going to be broadcasting that. I don't have the names of the people that are going to be there, but they're big names, and they will be, I think, talking about running for certain offices so that we can get rid of some corrupt individuals. So we will be doing that later. Hope you can join us for that. And Jean's vaping. Excellent. Density says this is entertainment 2017. Agree.
Yeah.
Agree. Yes. Screwy Saturdays with the Revolution Crew. Thank you. With the Revolution Crew and the disappearing online audience, because we seem to be losing more subscribers than we gain monthly. So I'm still glad that you're all still here, whoever you are. The dwindling audience that it is. No, really. The family, we've all been, we're just, our bubble is intact. We've had the same bubble. Those that are leaving are just the outliers left over from old Bernie. That, whatever. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. That's why the Cam Boys and the Dan Rather. So, here. Dan Rather. This is, I'm just going to leave the full thing up on screen. Maybe I'll cut back to me, but it's small lettering. And I want you to read it. This is Dan. I have to remember to take a breath. Bam, bam, bam. Blockbuster developments hit in the news cycle in rapid succession on an administration that many fear has been severely compromised, even while we hope it is not. Bam, bam, bam. My head spins. My heart sinks. I do not know what the next moment will bring, let alone the next hour, day, week, or heaven forbid, month. The latest bombshells from the last few hours rise to the level of screaming headlines worthy of a Hollywood script. President Trump apparently telling Russian officials that firing the FBI director relieved great pressure on him, courtesy of the New York Times. And then an even bigger development. White House advisor close to Trump is a person of interest in Russia probe. Bam, from the Washington Post. Thank God for the free press. The pressure mounts. The fantastic becomes unbelievable. The unbelievable becomes the believable. The believable becomes old news. All within a matter of hours. I have never seen a story of this nature move so fast. It reminds me of a forest fire devouring dry timber. But what is burning is the very structure of our democracy. My hope is that it is such a raging inferno that even the most cynical members of Mr. Trump's party could not ignore the flames. We are well past wondering whether the smoke suggests a fire. Dan Rather. That's where we sit.
Yep.
That's, I mean, you can argue it's Russia, it's not Russia, it's Hillary, it's Obama, whatever. You can argue about petty aspects. The truth of the matter is, we are unraveling massive corruption within our government, and there's more to fall, and there will be corrupt individuals that are going to work quickly to cover up and survive in this. And in the end of this toppling, it will still be a corrupt organization that controls our government. But we will have exposed many individuals that we previously had no idea of their level of corruption. And that's important. That's important when you can rake back the wall and see some of the bullshit going on. Because we will be waking up millions more Americans because MSM cannot avoid this story. Right? That's what's important here. In the end, there will be an orange idiot standing on Marine One waving bye-bye. And you can all argue right now that Mike Pence is worse, and I do not disagree with you at all. I'm excited for Mike Pence. Right? Because Mike Pence isn't going to spend his time on Twitter. Mike Pence is going to spend his time deconstructing the freedom that we have left in the United States of America. And that's going to wake us up even faster. So I am very excited for this collapse. And I know Scott didn't think it was going to happen this fast. I've been talking to Scott about this. And Scott's gone from it doesn't matter to mind-boggling to maybe. In terms of where we sit. That's pretty impressive for Scott, who has always been the harshest cynic in terms of seeing our government fix itself. Right? I see Markus. Uh-huh. Yes, it did. Comments, Markus? Yeah. How do you feel about that?
Yeah. If Scott says it, I think we saw it during the primaries. Everything what Scott said, it turned out to be true, and if he says this, I'm impressed, and and he's normally very careful about this, and we will see what will happen.
Exactly. We got a lot more to do, we got a lot more work to do, but this is an unexpected boon. Let's put it that way. In the realm of war, in this particular theater. This is a great thing, all right. So we need to take advantage of this. This does not mean we slow down or stop or do anything different in the revolution. It just means we take advantage of it. Right? It's an opportunity. It's an opportunity to
but
clean
I'm
house.
Not sure.
What, Markus?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure if you're right about Pence, because the moment 45 disappears from the stage and Pence comes on, there will be all the distracting scandals and everyday bullshit. These times are over then, and maybe the people who are now demonstrating or are against Trump would be fall back into sleep. And I think, what do you think about this, John?
He's going to cause so much destruction and damage, and Pence's damage is going to hit rural America more, in my opinion, than Trump's damage. Trump's damage is more of an optics damage to the United States of America. All right. Pence's damage is going to be actually physical damage by installing an abusive, more militarized law enforcement across. I mean, he wants to wage war against anything he doesn't believe in. And that includes women, cannabis, the entire LGBTQ community, anybody who's not white. He wants to bring it on. He wants to bring it on physically, not on Twitter.
Yeah.
Pence doesn't give a fuck about Twitter. Pence doesn't even know how to use Twitter. I don't even think he has a fucking Twitter account. Right? I mean, that's the difference. Trump is a fucking child, a buffoon. Pence is a sadistic, scary fucking man. He's going to...
This makes him more dangerous somehow.
Which is great. It's great.
I don't think we should underestimate the media for being, or anybody else for being able to come up with scandals and distractions, no matter who's in office.
Well, I agree, but right? I think the American people are going to be, when they're like, you know, at home, this is going on. I'm uh-huh. way more concerned about that when they're, you know, when it's happening in their community. Hey, my neighborhood just got raided by a bunch of ICE agents looking for anybody not white, and they took away three of my friends. That's what I'm talking about. When that's happening more, that's it compared to, you know, they're going to be paying more attention to that than they are to today on the news. It was discovered that Mike Pence also likes to jerk off and think about Mrs. Butterworth secretly and blah, blah, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
It's
I don't think there's any worries about people going back to sleep. This is not time for sleeping.
Hey, wait a minute. Yeah. Wait a minute, guys. I'm seeing that there's a live. You guys want to cut over to Bernie? If you drop me link, I'll cut to Bernie. Did you guys drop me link? Do you want to go to Bernie?
What?
I'm seeing that Bernie's live right now on a Fox affiliate. Okay. If it's a Fox local, I can grab it. If it's Fox national, I cannot. That's the deal there.
Right? If we can't have Bernie, we should bring Bernie.
I agree.
And the hashtag is Big Sky Burn, by the way, that they've got for this whole weekend.
Darcy, I guess there is a Saturday show. What did you think? There wasn't a Saturday? Because we're going to broadcast... This Saturday show is, if there's a Bernie, we'll bring it. That's what it is, everybody.
Yeah.
Because I really didn't have a, I don't, Laura, you, I mean, Laura was looking earlier for us, and she said that the one that we could possibly do was at like 7. So I was thinking, you know, as long as I'm not dead ass tired after the other one, we'll do that. But if we can.
The big night rally is the one. They just moved it to a bigger stadium. Yeah. So it's.
Yeah. Great. We're gonna. Yeah, they had to move two of them. Hey, Revolution Funding. Good to see you. How you doing? Good to see you. Springfield Progress. How you doing, Darce? Louise. Oh. Who sent me this? Was it Kendrick?
Kendra. Yeah. You said Kendra.
I didn't show this yet. I didn't show this. Thank you, Kendra Heidkamp, for your Photoshop work. Before we cut to Bernie, everybody. Please screen grab and share with Sheriff David Clark. Let him know that if he wants some extra bling, we can provide.
Kendra. Oh my God, he's like an ADD Boy Scout.
Yes. I have all the merit badges. Yeah. He has all the, and he feels so good about his inadequacy. So just, you know. Yeah. Share that with David Clark. Let him know that whatever uniform he wants to wear, I'm waiting for a cape. Cape is next, right? When we add the cape, you know it's gone. Did he lose his sash? Did he? A sash? Yeah, they need. See, it's so much better to make fun of the evil, oppressive overlords than it is to just get angry at them, right?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Make fun of them. All right, are you guys dropping a link to this or no? Do we have a link to this? Are we not going? What's the deal?
I don't know. I'm talking to you guys. I saw somebody else in chat was dropping a link.
All right. Well, if we don't get it in Slack, I can't do anything with it. It's got to go. Not you, Laura. I'm talking to
Yeah.
Hey, crowd, audience, it's your job. Grab the link, get it to us.
Yeah, gleaners.
Glean. Yeah, what's going on here? Ah, what a great show. I can watch it. I can see the numbers just dropping like. never mind. Okay, so later today we do have the Take Back Our Healthcare rally that is in Des Moines. Scott's broadcasting that. Join us for that. And we also have What do we got here? Actually, let me see if I can find the names of some of the people going to be on this. The host is Madeline Anderson. There you go. Name a person. And then there's the Rob Quiz stuff. Hopefully, we'll be grabbing that. There's one at tonight at 7 Pacific.
7:30.
7:30 yeah. Pacific? All right, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's 8:30 Mountain Time.
I'll do that. I'll do that one if we can find a stream. Was that a stream that you'd found for sure? Or
They said that it's going to be live on their Facebook page. Montanans for Bernie Sanders Facebook
great.
Page.
Great.
So that if that works, I can't. They don't have an event planned for it, but they did mention that it's going to be streamed live there, and that is the big one. You know, the nighttime good. Stadium.
Here to help ratings and maybe to get YouTube to grab this video. You guys are wondering. I still have it. Here's
for podcast viewers. It's our Donald Trump blow up doll. Yes.
Can you hear it? Can you hear the crash? Yeah.
Put a scarf over that. There you go. Oh my God.
Now in German TV, would this even work in German TV? You guys have such higher standards. This could be German children's TV, guys.
It would depend on the show, and it could work, but it must not work. But what is most important is it works in the wake with John and Markus and Laura.
Yes, it does.
And Dennis.
All right.
Ah, Andy just dropped a live stream.
All right. I know you guys want to see that more than you want to see the Trump doll. I just had to prove that it was still around. Here, let's everybody. Somebody asked. Here, let's everybody look at David Clark with all his bling, yeah. Bling Clark.
I just dropped it in live production.
David Clark blings it. All right, here we go.
Blings it on. Bling it yeah, on.
Just bling it.
There.
Oh, I can hear Bernie.
All right, we're switching over to Bernie. Everybody, we'll talk about German healthcare later.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is that okay with you guys?
Yeah, of course.
Absolutely.
It's Bernie.
Exactly.
Hang on, almost there. The sound is as good as I can find it. This is the source stream for just about everybody else. If somebody can find a different source, it may have better audio.
There is something profoundly wrong in America when we pay fulfill that prescription. Because the prices that the drug companies charge are so outrageous. How crazy obscene is it that in Montana and Vermont, you got senior citizens who are cutting their pills in half because they cannot afford the medicine they need.
Their budget, in terms of their tax ideas, He is not standing with the working families. He is standing with the billionaire class. I want to just give you one example of how horrific these ideas are, how dangerous they are. President Trump wants to repeal the estate tax. The estate tax would provide, the repeal of the estate tax would provide over $300 billion in tax breaks to the top 0.2%. Got that? 99.8% of the people would not get a nickel benefit. The Walton family, the wealthiest family in America, would get up to a $50 billion tax break. The Koch brothers family would get up to a $30 billion tax break. The Trump family would get up to a $4 billion tax break. As they are talking about unbelievable tax breaks for the wealthiest people in this country, their budget says that we have got to cut Head Start, we've got to cut child care, we've got to cut Pell Grants, we've got to cut the WIC program. This is a program for low-income women and their babies, a nutrition. The Trump budget would cut the Meals on Wheels program, which is a program in which low-income seniors get one nutritious meal a day. It is really hard to believe that we have people in Congress who think that it is acceptable for billionaires to get massive tax breaks, and then you cut programs that are desperately needed by children, by the elderly, by veterans, by the sick and the poor. Rob Quist is going to Congress to change those priorities.
because they got the education they need, we're going to lower student debt. And when we talk about protecting the beauty of Montana and Vermont and our incredibly beautiful country, Rob understands that the president has it wrong. Climate change is not a hoax. Which is broken. We have more people in jail than any other country on earth. And you know, and I know, and Rob knows, that it makes a hell of a lot more sense to be investing in jobs and education for our young people rather than jails and incarceration. Is when we bring our people together. Black and white, and Latino and Asian American and Native American. And we will not allow anybody for cheap political points to divide us up. We stand together. Express my admiration and respect for the Native American people. These are our people who have been lied to, who have been cheated since the inception of this country, and it is time we did them wrong. Native American kids, and he has been deeply influenced by Native American culture, as all of us should be. Because they have taught us that when we destroy our land and our water and our atmosphere, when we destroy the environment, we are destroying ourselves.
Because the people of America know that if you can do it in Montana, to working families in the middle class and not just the billionaire class. That's what this campaign is. You know, when Rob began this campaign, he was a well, he's a nice guy, he's an interesting guy, a musician, poet, a songwriter. Wow, that's cute, that's cool. But nobody thought he had a chance to win. But now, a week before the election, our Republican friends are getting nervous, and they should get nervous. So our job is right now, you guys can make a profound difference. Not only must you come out to vote, bring your friends with you. I think we got something like 4,000 people here. Each one of you bring one or two people, we get 8,000 more votes for all. That's not that hard. So thank you all very much. Thank you very much. And I say this from the bottom of my heart, because these are difficult moments for America, and a lot of people are kind of giving up and they're throwing their hands up and they are living in despair. But what you understand, now is not the time to give up. Now is the time to fight back.
Well, don't be surprised if this video gets cut off here in a minute, because that was Starman, and they don't like me running that song, so hate it when they run that commercial stuff. That's Bernie Sanders, though, and it doesn't look to me like Rob Quist is coming out. It looks like Bernie was the closing act there, so unfortunate, because I was kind of hoping we'd get to hear Rob, if not speak, sing, you know. Grandma Christine was asking people, have you ever heard him sing? I'm like, no. I haven't heard him do anything. Anybody else?
I don't know, but if he really wants to sing and the people are leaving, then obviously he's not a good singer.
No, I'm pretty sure he would have sung earlier, right? That's what I'm saying.
It's, yeah, of course.
Good point, Markus. You know,
thank you.
If he's coming up now, he obviously sucks. No one wants. That's very nice. Way to support Rob from Germany. Thank you so much.
Hey, I'm not referring to him as a politician, you know.
I know. Laura, we can't hear you if you're talking. I got no audio on you.
Sorry, I've got a YouTube of him singing his campaign song.
Oh, yeah? All right, well, maybe we'll play that in a little bit.
Okay. It's in
Yes, Melissa, you can find him singing on YouTube. Yes, we could. We'd probably play it, too. I don't know. We'll play. That was good. We caught most of Bernie there. And it sounded like we had a whole bunch of very inspired, cheering people. How many people we know were there? I saw different numbers floating around, but I wasn't sure what numbers were what. One number looked like people in chat. There can't be 10,000 people there.
Somebody said there were 7,500 people that the venue
really
sat 7,500.
Oh,
but who knows? These things, there could have been people overflowing all over the place.
There's definitely a big crowd. There's still more people than Hillary usually got. Remember that, you know.
That's only his first one of the day. He's got two more. Bernie's doing two more rallies there in Montana today and going to a fundraising dinner tonight.
So. I know. It's awesome.
Oh, cool.
It's awesome. And hopefully we'll get the later one, and hopefully there'll be a little better audio. I don't know what the deal was there. It sounded like ABC or whoever. Yeah, ABC Fox. ABC Fox Montana. Does that make sense? ABC Fox. It sounds like they had like some weird audio going on there. It was really bizarre. Who's got no sound? You've got no sound? I see sound going all over the place for me. Mm-hmm. You guys have no sound? I don't know.
I'm seeing a couple people say that. Bev said that.
It's here.
It's on your end.
Oh well. I'm sorry. I don't know what to do. Let me see where we're at here in the show. Always.
There's sound right now.
Oh, good.
I just checked the live stream.
Springfield, John, would you like to predict when we will have single payer? After for nationally, not till 2020. At least. What, Dennis? What was that?
I think that's the only date which will happen.
Yeah, if anything, it's going to happen. There's sound in Vermont. Vermont has sound, everybody. Good to know.
Yay!
That's good to know.
All the Bernie Krebs has sound.
Yay. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for MSNBC is showing and speaking about this campaign, by the way. They show it is over. Well, what are they saying? Rob lost already? is Wolf Blitzer trying to get in his, you know, Rob has no chance at all. Are they already with that narrative? That'd be hilarious.
Wouldn't the election is Thursday, so we will find out.
Oh, Thursday. It's that soon? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Primary,
we're just going to talk about this right now. Because I had these things pulled up to do this, and so we might as well just do it while we just watched Bernie. First of all, Laura talked about this. Venues changed for two of these appearances in Montana because they want to see Bernie, and mm-hmm. Bernie supports Rob, and Rob supports Bernie, and that's a wonderful thing. So the Missoula event has been moved. Was that the one we just watched? Which one did we just watch?
I don't know. I've just got the times.
Where? 10, somewhere. 12, 10, 12, all right. Sorry, go ahead.
No, I just had the times.
Oh,
okay.
Locations. So the Billings one is moved. That rally begins at 8:30. That sounds like the evening one tonight.
That's the evening one. Okay. Yeah, they moved to a bigger park, Metro Park or something like that.
So that's good news. I remember this happening back in the primaries. Bernie Sanders books this place and all of a sudden needs the fucking stadium because 20,000 people want to see Bernie Sanders. The populist movement.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Again.
And yeah, we're doing this again. Bev, your audio was off. You guys.
Oh, Bev.
That never happens. Laura Live half the time. She's like going off on something and can't hear you. Anyway.
That's probably for the best, John.
Audio was good on the people with Bernie Sanders on Facebook. Yes, Bev, but they were using the same source feed. So that's why I didn't switch. It was just the same source feed from ABC Fox. Maybe they had it running through something different. You know, I don't know. Anyway, that's the fun about scraping it through a volunteer network and run out of your garage, right? So you never know what you're going to get. Right? So, build your own volunteer network in the garage. No, just kidding. Right.
Yes.
That's why we're all here.
We have three bedrooms and a garage.
Yes.
Windows started in the garage, so
what?
Think big,
what?
John.
What was that, Dennis?
Windows started in the garage, so John,
Apple started in a garage.
Yeah, oh no.
Also.
You guys, I already had that. I already went through. I have my Steve Jobs story. Just like I am the cheap Catholic version of John Stewart, I am the cheap Catholic version of those guys. You know, I created this engagement broadcasting technology about 5 years ago. I've been improving on it. My original company was started in the garage, Portland Internet Design. We froze our fucking asses off that first winter because it didn't have heat in that garage. And, You know, yeah, I could write a great book about the non-success of my engagement broadcast technology over the last 5 years and why I just ended up using it for volunteer work to help save the fucking planet. Nobody cares about that movie. Nobody cares. That's not a movie. Who the fuck about that, right? That's not, I didn't make $1 billion, right? We gathered 300 people a day to watch a show. And we broadcast Bernie. We have a fun time together. That's what we do. Mm-hmm. There's people doing this shit all over on all sorts of channels everywhere. It's just, how do we have a conversation while we watch the world die and try to fix it?
Yeah. That's money is not everything.
Bernie is what?
Money. Money's not everything.
No, money is, yeah. We're all kind of there. A lot of us are all kind of there. You may be the next Apple. Yeah, I'm more like a pear. I don't know. But I get what you're saying. you know, it's. I'm just glad you guys are here. That's what it is. I am following in my grandfather's and father's footsteps. This is exactly what our genetics do. We create things and we give them away.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Interesting.
I'm all right with that. Mm-hmm. Sorry about that. Really quick, just that was the other. Where's the Rob? Quit the other Rob thing. I had one other Rob thing. Where the hell did it go? Oh, it was just the money. We have raised more than $5 million for Rob, and the GOP is worried. They're freaking. So we need to raise more money for Rob. He needs even more by Thursday, okay, so we can run as many ads as he can. Rob is still not winning in the polls, as far as I understand, and the GOP can still pull out all the stops. They could still just cheat. You realize they could just cheat and cheat, and there's nothing we can do about that. But we should give Rob as much money as we can so that he can run as many ads as we can. So that the possibility of cheating is less. Say that. All right. Just we have to fight with the fuel that this war takes. Money. Donate to Rob if you can. I am. Thank you, Springfield. I'm fun today. That's exciting. I was feeling really melancholy. We're going out with a melancholy song because I was not feeling fun at all, really. Not at all. Then we got then Dennis started laughing, reminded me of Belushi, and Bev says fuck. Why are you saying fuck, Bev? What's fuck for? I mean, not like you don't need a justification. You can say fuck anytime. You have the freedom to say fuck. You do. Yeah.
Really?
Best looking pair I've ever seen, Jim. Thank you, Jim. And that's just a pair in terms of my mind, in terms of shape. Okay. I'm more like a stick. All right. Like I'm stick. I'm a stick. Never mind. I'm not even going to go there. Why am I making the analogy? Who gives a fuck about any of this shit? It's the dumbest shit ever.
Hey, Melissa says that Rob is up 7 points in the latest poll in an article today. So
I thought he was behind. I thought he was behind. Shit. Did Hitler have a comb over too? He just had a bad look. Yeah.
Mustache.
But that was popular at the time. That was like the popular look. That's what's sad. Like the I put some oil in my hair and combed it one direction look. That was that was popular.
The Nazi look.
Yeah, the Nazi look. It's just sad that it got associated with the, you know, it wasn't associated with it before. It was just a dude in that time period, right? A lot of dudes look the same, dressed the same. Certainly doesn't happen today in white USA America. Not at all. We're all individuals over here. Fuck you. What Springfield? Wow, what? Oh, in the points, up 7 points. Yeah, it's fantastic. This is conversational therapy. It's certainly not real therapy. Don't ever think that. Next week, Wednesday, Sam Ronan, he's going to be on We the People. And let's hope we actually do him some good. He's running for First District, Ohio, as a candidate. And we just know, being that he's a progressive, he's going to be trying to replace somebody who's not.
Mm-hmm.
That's just the way it is.
Entrenched Republican.
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. DNC doesn't need votes to win. No, they can cheat. You guys understand that that's still, in terms of the war effort, that's still okay. Because when they cheat, we will know, and more Americans will be pissed. It's everything they can do to be down and dirty, to beat us, just in the end throws fuel on the fire. Mm-hmm. And we already know there's a fire. Dan talked about it this morning. It's not just smoke. We have a fire. And it's not just a fire in the White House. It's the whole fucking USA is on fire governmentally. The people are pissed. We're rising up all over the place. They can go ahead and continue to fight us, continue to battle us, but the people are going to beat their government into submission. with votes, with verbal threats, with showing up at their homes, right? That's what you do when you create an angry mob. That angry mob is going to rise up and do things. And first they're going to try to do things without violence, and then they're going to break out the sticks. That's what we do. What we do. Yes, what are you, Dennis is over there raising his hand as the as German too.
No.
No? No. Hey, you put on glasses to look smarter. That's an American tactic.
For peaceful protests.
What? Say they get,
like Andy.
Well, what's it called? You, what did you say about peaceful protest?
I would say the best way to transform a country is to do it like Gandhi.
Yeah.
Without violence. Okay, I know the American narrative is a little bit different, but I don't know.
Well, we're there with you, but I think the change, Dennis. Although this is not what we're supposed to talk about with you. This is not you're supposed to talk about other things. But that's okay. No. We could. You're not supposed to know about any of this shit. No. You see very different things being in Germany and being in Turkey. Let me just ask you this: how well do you think peaceful protests be working in Turkey right now?
Not really.
Okay. I see. In America, we're striving to be Turkey. We talked about this earlier, right? We want to be like Turkey. We want to have the Turkish healthcare system, which is worse than ours, which is unbelievable. It's, you know, we really want to divide it up by cash. We really want to have oppressive leaders that beat the shit out of people. You have that going on in Turkey. I mean, I say you, but it's because you've got family. Everybody meet Dennis for real. Hey, Dennis. We're going to talk about healthcare. Maybe we just flip over that direction right now, because Dennis has had a unique perspective of experiencing healthcare services in whatever general in three different countries, right? Right. And tell everybody your heritage, what your background is.
Okay, my father is from Turkey, Ankara. My mom comes from Germany, so I have. I was raised in the faith of Islam. I'm a Muslim, so that way I have a different perspective from the start. Where do you like to start? Germany, Turkey, or whatever?
Well, you know, let's start with who's got the worst system of the three?
Turkey.
Turkey, okay.
And the problem in Turkey.
Go ahead. Yeah, why? Why? Why is Turkey worse?
The problem in Turkey is we know bribery. It's a big topic in Turkey. If you don't have the money to pay the doctor, he's doing nothing. He gives a shit about you. In Turkey, they have something like single payer, but it is so limited to. How do I describe it? For example, if you make I'm so nervous. Sorry, guys.
It's all right.
No problem.
Here, we're going to put you on with it now. You've got Markus and me. We'll just make funny faces.
Yeah, here we go.
The big problem is bribery. If you don't have the money, you are fucked. Simple as that.
Yes.
And the care you get for that money is so horrible.
No.
For example, my aunt, the big sister of my father, she got a heart surgery, and after the surgery, they kicked her out right out the hospital and say, "Hey, have fun. We don't care about you."
Jeez. Well, they're at that. So in America, just by contrast, everybody, we're at the point where doctors are starting to ask, "Do you have money? Can you afford this?" And if people say no, they turn them away, right? Which is not the way it used to be here. So we're there. We're not quite to Turkey's awesome level of douchebaggery. That's a whole new level there. So just pause on that for a second. Pause for 1 second.
Yeah.
We have just a couple questions in the audience. I do want to ask, but you're only allowed to give like a 30-second response. Not even a 30. Okay. Just like a one sentence. All right.
Okay.
A tweet. You get to tweet respond. Okay. Like you were Trump about these things. So the first tweet response is, what are your feelings on Erdogan or whatever his fucking name is?
Erdogan.
Whatever this fucking name is. Dickwad. What do you think about him?
only thing I want to say to Elgon, fuck you.
Right. There you go. All right.
That's pretty clear.
That's pretty clear. There's your opinion on that. And there's something else. Oh, and the other one is, how do you feel about Cenk Uygur, being that he's Turkish?
I don't like him.
Why don't you like him? Which probably has nothing to do with his heritage.
No. The problem I have with Cenk is he's a little bit dickish. He thinks he's a boss. Do you know what I mean with
yes,
that?
Yes, I do. I do.
Yeah.
When I see TYT panels, everyone has his opinion and gives something to the conversation. But at the end, the last word only and always has to do Cenk some. Damn it!
I know what you're saying. It's kind of like he's got a little bit of an ego going, right? Just a little bit of an ego. Right?
Yeah, the problem with it, Cenk, is how could I describe it? He's a little bit like Alex Jones.
What?
Wow. Okay. You gotta explain this.
Interesting.
Isn't Alex Jones just batshit crazy? What?
And he and Alex Jones are enemies.
I mean, in the way he articulates, say something, in what way, and she's like, whoa. I don't know how to describe it better.
Wow.
I stopped TYT because of Cenk.
Oh, wow.
I think I know what you mean. Cenk is sometimes a little over exaggerating, in my opinion. But Alex Jones is not comparable to Cenk Uygur, in my opinion.
No, because
Alex Jones is a mad dog. He is literally a mad dog.
And he lives the first thing. You're looking at the sensationalism of. I understand where you're going.
Yeah.
What do you think of? So forget. Cenk, he just created TYT, which he has a right to be very proud of. It's a huge organization, and he did a lot of work there, and I have a lot of respect for what he's done. What do you think of the news reporting, the discussion that's going on TYT? Because a lot of people are complaining that it's corporate now, or it's owner, whatever. I don't even know, because I don't watch either. I don't have time. What do you guys think of that? Dennis, you don't know because you don't watch it anymore?
No. I can't remember. I have a brain like an elephant. I don't forget anything. The thing is with TRT, they're starting to sound like, in some cases, like MSN.
Hmm. Interesting. Interesting.
Okay. In my personal opinion.
Markus, okay. Thoughts?
I cannot speak for the TIT formats because I rarely watch them, but I can only refer to Jimmy Dore, which is part of TYT. Yeah. And Jimmy, I love Jimmy Dore, and
I love him too. I watch him every day.
All right, so we all agree Jimmy Dore is great.
Okay, we get this. With TYT, it was in after the primaries when I got problems with TYT because it was so easy for Cenk to turn from Bernie to Hillary, and this was a little bit strange in my opinion. And if he starts to build up or increase his TYT, then I think it's okay. But we have to be careful, or he has to be careful, that he doesn't get into the mainstream trap, you know. And I don't see it right now because I think I still think they're independent. I'm not talking about the AJ Goodman thingy there, which was running in the past weeks, but I think in general they are all right, you know, from what I know.
I'll go with you there.
I would agree with that. I like they keep on the right topics. You know, they don't run chasing too many of the false flags. I think since the election, they have gotten increasingly careful about what they say, a little bit more structured, a little bit bigger, shinier desks. But at least they are talking about the things that matter,
right?
And not complete mouthpieces for.
That's kind of really where I sit. Like, as long as they're helping to inform the electorate and they're doing it in a way where they haven't put more entertainment into their content than information, which is where we sit with MSM. It's more of a fantasy land bullshit for the sake of profit. I don't see that coming out of TYT, regardless of what I think of individuals in it or some of the reporting or whatever's going, you know, they're working for the greater good. They're not perfect. They're human, right? They're reaching more people than I am, than we are here.
Yeah.
Right? And that's, That's what's important
for
me.
We could spend a lot of time looking for ways to not like things or not approve of things, and that's just a fucking waste of time. I would rather people focus on what is good, what's positive. Not everything's going to be perfect. We're in a revolution here. We're trying to get something done, and there's so many people out there who are just going to jump on the first little thing that's like, but that's not going the way I want it, and so therefore their whole message is bad, and I disagree with that.
Yeah, I agree. Right. Exactly. All right, so we were talking about healthcare, and we just told Dennis to stop it while we talked about something else. I don't even remember why. But now we're gonna come back to the healthcare part. Now that we've all talked about TYT and Jimmy Dore and everybody and all that stuff, and just knowing this is where we sit with independent media, it's good that we all kind of keep an eye on each other. We need to do that, right? I guarantee you, in social media, both Jank and HA and everybody that was involved in the little tiff spat going on there heard from everybody else saying, why don't you guys shut the fuck up and get back to news, right? And you know, the little tiff has died and everybody gets back to work. But that's human beings working in a new office space together, right? The office space, that's the way it was. So, all right, Dennis, we were talking about healthcare. We defined Turkish healthcare as bad because it's a downward spiral from where American healthcare is. And you've got a dick face for a leader, and that's not good. I mean, your dick face is worse than our dick face in many ways, because I think he's just a serious, like, wants to hurt people, whereas our guy just wants to prove he's got a big dick. Really? That's
exactly.
How many times did I get the word dick in that intro? Yeah. That's a lot of dick.
quota today. So.
From what you said, Dennis, that your sister had a heart surgery and was thrown out. I'm sorry?
My aunt.
Your aunt.
Your aunt, okay. Your aunt had a heart surgery and was thrown out of hospital one day later or after the surgery. If she would have paid them more money, would it be a problem for her to stay in the hospital?
No, it's all about the money.
Okay, this is where both healthcare systems in the U.S. are similar and different at the same time. Because while in the U.S. It is institutionalized that nothing is offered or only for extra with extra insurance and with extra primes, etc. In Turkey, is it, if you get the money, you can pay directly to the doctor, you know. And
well, that's, you know, only the rich deserve health care. So fuck you.
That's
basically what
it is. That's the way it is.
And very to the extreme in Turkey. And I mean, I'll just be honest. I don't know the history of that country. I just know it's a lot more violent than ours simply because it's been around longer. Yeah. And you guys keep getting sacked by numerous armies that come in and do things. And you know, that violence has to have had a long-term effect on the people in general. I can't even imagine. We've just begun a little bit of that. So let's move to country two. What's the second worst country of the three you've experienced?
USA.
Well, number two is not bad. I'm okay with that. Moving on. We're number two. Ooh, fuck you. We're number two. Fuck you. All right. I'm good. This is all I needed.
But the number two is something you don't have to be proud of.
No. What if I painted gold, put a 45 on it? Huh?
Sorry.
Yeah.
So where do you see the differences right now between the Turkish healthcare system and the United States healthcare system?
I would like to start to the thing is, we just have to start around a debate about the concept, how you structure the whole thing, or the thinking of the people. For example, in America, the structure of the inner mind is all about me. I have my problems, you have your problems. I take care of myself, you take care of yourself.
Yeah.
The thing is, in all the other Western countries, we have a concept of the thinking of we. We are all in the boat together. We swim or sink together. In that way, all healthcare systems are designed.
Well,
that is my impression. But I get when in the 6 months I was in, where I stayed in the States.
Right.
This was my experience I had with the American people, with the friends that I made, and so on. When I talked about the things I have in Germany, they say, "Oh no, this can't be possible. You're lying. You're communist or whatever." And the best thing is, I'm not really a German. I have mixed heritage. This stereotype they are saying to me, "Oh, here's a little Turkish Nazi from Germany."
Really?
And that shows you the ignorance that is spreading, that's in the minds of really, really the most people I met. And I don't want to say that's all American. You, John, and all the others are awake and seeing what's happening and so on. But the ignorance, this is the biggest problem around the world.
And you saw that in America. Yes. You saw that in America, but you were, your healthcare experience there was, I mean, I don't doubt for one moment that you saw, you experienced racism in America because it's everywhere. All right.
Back to healthcare. I was fortunate that I have the private insurance. I was fortunate I had to buy a private health insurance in Germany before I get to the US. This was something in the program I had to buy because I was taught in America you have to pay all out of your pocket. So my parents said, "Okay, Dennis, we are not rich. You have to take this this insurance. It costs around $20 a month, and it's all covered for you."
Was that part of your you were there for
an exchange.
Exchange student. Was that part of the exchange student services processes?
No. That's no. I had to buy it by myself.
Okay. I mean, but was it offered through the exchange service process because they knew it had to happen? I guess is what I'm saying. I know you had to pay for it yourself.
No. Okay. No. That was a family thing.
Okay. When you got to the United States of America, did you have to utilize that? Did they treat you differently because you were an exchange student as opposed to just an immigrant, an illegal alien on our soil?
No. The service that I got and all the things were superb.
Right.
Really. But I got a really bad feeling because I met some people in the waiting rooms and so on. And they told me a little bit about their stories. And I said, "What the fuck is going on?"
Wow. So you heard personal experiences from Americans in the hospital while you were there as an exchange student. Yeah, and you're like, what the fuck are you people doing over here?
I broke my left leg.
You broke your left leg? Is that what happened as an exchange student?
Yeah.
Well,
it got a bit wild on the party. Don't want to say anymore.
So you got invited and broke your leg. I see.
Yeah.
See that, Markus? I use that.
Now the thing, of course, when I got in the emergency room, but that is a typical thing where Americans get their healthcare.
Yeah.
They saw my insurance, and in that moment, I saw they treated me differently, because they knew they can jack off my insurance, because it doesn't matter how much it would cost me in America, my insurance. My German insurance would pay everything.
Right, so they said everything. And you need a CAT scan.
but the insurance only cost me 20 euros a month.
Right. Most Americans could afford that, actually, if it covered everything.
Because those kind of insurance are subsidized by the government. So that means by the German society in the whole.
Wow. You mean Markus? Markus had to help cover your goddamn insurance when you came over to America. How do you feel about that, Markus? What an asshole!
I would feel.
It's like, I'm going to America.
Okay, I'm a fortune. My father arbeited. My father works in the insurance
Does he really? Seriously?
Yeah.
So all questions and answers.
Companies.
In America, that just
means... Normally people don't get the insurance that I get, but okay.
No? No? So your story is not typical at all? So we're just...
What? No, it would cost a lot more for other people.
How much would it cost a month if you didn't have a father who worked for the insurance industry?
I don't know exactly. But I know it would cost a lot more. Don't want to say a false number or something.
Well, I mean... Okay, so you paid for extra insurance. You had insurance, gave to America, you got it. They would have treated you better anyway because you're an exchange student, right? When you've got an exchange student.
I saw my passport, I'm from Germany, and therefore I recognized they treated me differently.
Yeah, metalhead. Oh, the irony, Dennis. Yeah. That's like a bombshell. You didn't tell me that afterwards. Like Luke, I'm your father kind of drops. And by the way, Dad works for the health insurance industry. And so I got it for really cheap. Yeah. But that's all right. Yeah. That's all right. You don't need to have a father in the healthcare industry to get good healthcare in Germany, though, do you?
No. We have a public funded healthcare system that is mixed. The insurance comes from the government. Also, everyone pays... it's 50% of your income, but this 50% are cut, which Markus, help me please.
It's 50%. You guys pay 50% taxes?
15, I think. 15
It's half employer and employee, so that means 7.5%.
Oh, 15
and 7.5% my employee. Recurring. So they come total to a 15% for the whole health insurance.
Both the employer and employee both
pay in the share funds.
share the complete sum 50-50.
Yeah.
Interesting. All right. So you guys, does that VAT tax, does it come out of that? Is that where someone comes from, is that totally separate thing from what you pay? When you're talking about, you're paying out of your pocket from your wage, it's coming out of your wage, that's 7.5%, and then your employer pays the other, government pays the other 7.5%. Is that how that works?
Right? No. We the employer pays 7% and the employee.
Right. That's what I just said. Yeah. And what's the VAT tax? That's a whole separate thing.
This goes to the budget, the complete budget, and the healthcare, the federal healthcare system is covered by this. Okay. And then you have another option to get private insurance, and this is what you can choose from. And you can get the federal insurance and have another insurance for a small amount, maybe for glasses, for teeth, or something else, you know, for dentists, etc. But these are only small extra insurance, about a maximum, I think, 15 or 20 euros a month.
90% of our population are under the public healthcare system.
90% are under the public healthcare option.
Yeah, 10% are not. They are private insurance. In the 10% are included employees, freelancers, and so on.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Not just rich fucks.
No.
Okay. Wow. That's impressive. I mean, that's
for really example, impressive. I was a employer before last year. I had the restaurant. I bought a private insurance.
So you were a restaurant owner. Are you a restaurant owner now? You have a restaurant?
Not now.
So you had a restaurant and you had to provide your own insurance. You had to do self.
Yeah.
Yes.
But you actually could afford to do so under your government's plan. It wasn't like some astronomical fee.
No. It's like tax reasons.
Right. No, I'm not asking what happened with the business. I'm saying here in America, it'd be like impossible. You've got businesses that run all the time as self-employed people that can't afford basic insurance costs. Ridiculous. If I were to try, when my little small business tried to look at providing healthcare, you can't even fucking, when you get to like 50 people, that's the problem. Like Rhonda, employer Rhonda, remember that Rhonda who was doing she was the Trump supporter. She's like, I can't afford to be nice to my employees. Fuck you. She was on the verge of 50 employees. Yeah, 50 employees. That's a shitload of money you got to pay. I mean, I'm not. You know, Rhonda should be put in healthcare, but in our current system, it's crazy. It's an overburden.
Would you like to contribute, or should I start?
What? Well, no, no, you know what, really, guys, we're going to have to carry this on another time. I just want to have you back on because Germans are good for ratings. And now I got my German cam boys.
Yeah. And,
like I said, I only accept cash now.
That's fine. Hey, Jilly Love, good to see you, by the way. It's 15, not 50, Jilly Love. 15. But let me, they explained how they pay. So here's how Fox News would cover those statistics. It's a 15% tax that the employer and employee have to pay. And on top of that, there is a VAT tax. And that VAT tax is another 18%. And that is how they pay. So total, you as a citizen would be paying 25% or more for health insurance if you lived in Germany. And then you'd be waiting for a year or more to have something like a kidney or maybe a heart valve replacement. This is what socialized medicine it is. 25% of your wages to go to wait for a year to have anything done. Why would you want that in America? There we go. I just took those numbers, blew them out of proportion, and made a fox out of it, because that's...
Can I say two little sentences about that?
Yes.
For example, I pay 39% of my income in taxes. The taxes for my health insurance are in this 39%. So it doesn't cost me more. You know what I mean?
I know. So, I was just bullshitting. I know it's actually affordable. You're telling us it's affordable. Every person I talk to who lives over there, my ex-wife lives over there. She has insurance. It's affordable. Yeah. She does not have a big high-paying job, let me tell you. Okay? It's not like my ex-wife is like, I'm an American living in Germany in the lap of luxury, right? I mean, she's just an average person working a normal-ass job over there, and she can afford insurance for herself, right? That doesn't happen in the United States fucking America, where you have a normal-ass job, you can afford where you live, and you can afford to live, not just survive. We were talking about that earlier, right? Decent survival. Yeah. That's the... We're searching for
That's
a decent
my
survival.
Concept.
We the people, in order to form a decent survival, have food, air, and water to breathe and drink.
We should go on with our church plans and call it the Church of Decent Survival.
The Church of Decent Survival. I absolutely agree. Here's
Antonio would be like our guru or what?
So we have a troll. I guess we have a troll in the audience named Fritz Carl.
Yeah.
And Fritz is spewing some stuff. I'm not really sure what.
He's got the Lee Harvey Oswald acted alone, killing JFK, and we're just throwing out. Maybe the autopsy might be a good piece of evidence.
We can get into that.
I know.
I saw Fritz throwing other stuff. Nice to have you in the audience, Fritz. Have you heard of the Dunning-Kruger? In fact, that's the title. It's not the. It's the Dunning. Just look that up, Dunning Kruger. Look that up. See if it fits. Look that up. I don't know. Anyway, we're top of the hour. We've talked about. We watched Bernie. What a fun show! This one will have some views. We watched Bernie together. We talked a little bit at the beginning. David Clark Bling Doll. That'd be a great. Talk about a doll for boys. Give them the David Clark Bling Doll. They just put as many pins on it as they want. Just a big push pin. Look at all my awards that mean nothing. Fritz is not a troll.
75 people watching.
75. Hi, all 75 people that hung out and stayed after the Bernie show. That's a pretty good size of thing going on. Later on today, 1:30, we'll have 1:30 my time, Pacific. Okay, 3:30 Central Standard Time. We will be bringing you a healthcare rally. That is Scott Galindez with the Live View Solo Unit out there in Des Moines, Iowa. And it's a rally for save our freaking healthcare, right? And so join us for that. That'll be fun. I'm going to start a half hour early. And I don't know who will be. Maybe there'll be some Germans still up. Maybe Laura will be around. Who knows? We'll just have a conversation, talk about things. And... what's going on in the there's a lot of dick thrown around in the audience again. What's with the dick in the chat, guys?
There's some debate going on. I think we all just need to drop it and let it go. And
it's
everybody breathe.
Yes.
All right. And let out all that ugly, right? Get all the dicks out.
Three deep breaths, everyone.
I didn't even get a chance to become melancholy.
This yoga exercise is named Hillary.
This yoga exercise is named. Put on your pantsuit pants and get ready to. Oh.
Walk through the woods.
Yeah, keep talking about her. That'll get me melancholy. Thank you, Marcus. Yeah. Thank you. What's your fault, Paula? Nothing. Oh, about the dicks in the chat. Did you bring the dicks to the chat, Paula?
She came in. We're in the middle of things and didn't get the context. So
Chili, but it was a dick fight. I don't need to really look very far to learn why we don't have a lot of views, Joy.
Hot check. Mine is where it belongs. Oh, yeah, everything is fine.
No, I'm just saying, go back. And I wasn't talking about positioning of my act. I was talking literal in the second sense, millennial definition. I just need to look back 10 seconds at this broadcast. And this is why. This is why. Watch the Bernie portion. It's good, yes. Solid content, suitable for everybody. Bev, are you now we're spouting ages again? 76? I don't even know what that is. I'm not even going off. All right.
28. We're people watching. People,
oh, how many watching? Good. We have people. Because oftentimes you guys just remind each other how old you are. And I thought that was what was happening. I thought maybe. No, 76. No, wait. 79.
Sorry, Bev.
I've forgotten how old that is. Never. Bev, that's totally not what's going on. I'm just.
They're just fucking around.
We got to end this show. We really, really do. We got to
end this. Yeah, let's do it. We have an hour and a half for lunch, and then we're coming back for the Des Moines rally.
Oh, my God, an hour and a half for lunch. Okay.
The S's are silent.
Are you ready? We're going really fast here. I love you all. We're going very fast. Check this out. So these game-changing solar panels are cheap and can be printed. Now everybody just needs to spend a couple grand on a printer. Really, 3D printed solar panels that we're not even going to watch the video on. Think about that. If you have a good 3D printer with supplies, what, 10 grand? I don't know. A really solid industrial one. Print so you could go in as a town, get yourself a printer, get the supplies, and start printing out solar panels. Why not? Why not make that a crowdsourced community effort? I think that would be great. Just print out solar panels for everybody. Brilliant idea. What's next? California grid sets record with 67% of power from renewables. All right.
Right on.
It just, they're blowing the doors out with wind energy and solar energy and all those things that California should be using for energy. It's a big step forward for them. California is going to basically create the West Coast wall of freedom, right? With us, Washington and Oregon kind of sandwiching. We're going to be the last stand of freedom, the wall. Right, against whatever's going on in the fascist government and yeah, so please come out this way when things get bad. Community centers, everything. All right, eggplant. Who dropped eggplant?
Somebody dropped an eggplant emoji, and I was just like,
nice,
of course.
And check it out, soup. Campbell Soup announces a new 4.4 megawatt solar array at its world headquarters near Soup's Going Solar. Most businesses, if you look. Most businesses are going with renewable energy because any business with a brain in its board is going to go renewable energy after we amortize and pay for all the things, make stockholders pay for it, and maybe blame the U.S. and get some tax money back. Basically, we get energy for free. Why wouldn't we do that? Right? It's energy for free. We don't want the citizens to have that. Fuck them. But our business, our Apple Donut and our Campbell Soup Factory and wherever else, fine. Our government buildings are going solar. While they regulate to keep us from not. Anyway, it's good of Campbell Soup. I'm happy for them. Impressed. All right. And now you guys can throw it out about how horrible Campbell Soup is and that they're full of GMOs and kill your body, whatever. I don't care. I say fucking soup, okay? I do.
Choose your battles, damn it.
What? Choose your battles. Look, I know, well, like with cereals, there's too many cereals that I like. If they're full of GMOs, it's too late now. Been eating them since I was a kid. It's too late. I'm going to keep eating those cereals. I just am. Sorry. It's the little thing I have in life to enjoy.
All right. Can I just tell us what cereals are like? Because we're all going to guess. And we're going to sit here and take over.
No, because we have to go. Because it's serious shit. Because we've got this rally coming up and things. But we could do that for next time. What cereals do you like? Cereals for the revolution, everybody. I go in phases. Well, don't forget the milk. No, don't forget the milk. Which the prices of things going up a lot. Think about that these days. All that stuff. Pretty bad. Cereals for the, yes, the new show. Cereals for Revolution. You make your own soup, Natalie May. I like to do that sometimes. I like to do that. You know, just depends. Depends. I still am a Campbell's tomato soup and grilled cheese sandwich.
Oh, God, yes.
Guy.
Ultimate.
Okay.
Comfort food.
It has to be that. And I am one of the freaks. Yes, I am one of the freaks from the East Coast that puts powdered sugar on my fucking grilled cheese sandwich. And I don't care what you say. It's the way it's done. Okay. It's the way it's done. You put ham on the inside and you put powdered sugar on top because that's the way mom made it for me when I was a kid.
Oh,
and
like a Monte Cristo.
Kind of. It's kind of like a Monte Cristo light because you don't deep fry the son of a bitch. And, you know, it's like.
It's not American.
Monte Cristo is basically, don't put it in your mouth. Just take it and cut open your heart and shove it in your chest because that's what it really is. It's just a giant death warrant to your body, but they taste so good sometimes. I used to live in, SoCal, but worked in LA. So we used to go to that one deli, the Jewish big deli at Cantor's. You want to have a Monte Cristo that will give you a heart attack in that's, you go to Cantor's in LA. Oh my God. I couldn't even finish the thing. It was ridiculous. Anyway.
Markus?
Not the point. Markus, are you gone? Are you frozen? What do you eat Monte Cristos? You ever heard of that, Markus? No.
No, I knew that you would ask me this. I've never heard it.
You guys don't have that kind of food over here, huh? See, when we discovered you could deep fry just about anything, organic or not, we went to it.
Yeah.
That's America's like.
That is the American way.
If I make a club sandwich. A Monte Cristo is a club sandwich built with French toast. French toast that's already been made. Okay. Then you build a club sandwich, bacon, and it's a club sandwich that includes Thanksgiving additives, like cranberry sauce, all right?
Yeah,
and,
okay.
Then you take that whole thing, and you dip it in additional batter, and then you deep fry the son of a bitch, and then you take it out and you put powdered sugar on it. That is a Monte Cristo. Okay? We should just send those to countries we want to take over. Here, have a Monte Cristo. You'll be dead in a week. That's really what we should do.
That hurts my feelings as a cook.
And why is it called Monte Cristo?
Fuck if I know. I really don't know.
We'll have to look that up. We'll report back later. Okay.
I don't know why. We'll have to look up why it's called a Monte Cristo. You put avocado, onion, and tomato on your grilled cheese. That's nice. Do you guys know that in Portland, macaroni and cheese, fancy-ass macaroni and cheese is a thing? Like with bacon and tomatoes and crumbles on top and all sorts of stuff. You can get it with a can of PBR in the middle. All sorts of things with your grilled cheese. All right, we're getting the hell out of here because I keep talking and we can't do that. I will see you guys.
I'm going to drop the Wikipedia link to Monte Cristo sandwiches so we can all learn about
them. Yes, please do. And we'll talk later about food, the revolution, whatnot, German healthcare, American non-care. All that stuff. We're actually going to go out with a song that works for either one of the moods I was going to be in. All right. It's whatever we're going to end up with today. Apparently, we ended up with happy. I don't know. It won't be afterwards.
Oh, God.
Chasing Emotional Curves with John. That's what we're doing here. You guys are going off to get, I know I'm hungry too. It's really hungry. This is Nick Drake. One of these things first, okay?
I love him.
Nick Drake is awesome. Well, was awesome. He's dead. But this song, One of These Things First, is, it's kind of a song about regret, but it's more of a, just kind of a look at life. I could have been these things. I could have been a sailor. I could have been a pot. I could have been a signpost, right? And then in relation to other people, right? He's talking about a relationship. I could have been a better friend to you. I could have been a lover. I could have listened, right? But the whole thing is like, I could have been one of these things first. I could have done this first. I could have gone back and not done all the drugs I could find in the universe at 19 and gone to college and got a degree and built my things in the garage and been, you know, Paul Allen. I could have done that and not done what I did with my 20s. I could have saved my second marriage possibly by not drinking myself to death almost twice and by being a better husband and by, you know, focusing more on the actual marriage. I could have done that, I suppose, been a better husband there. I could have been a better Democrat, a better citizen of the United States of America by, you know, being awake for a long time when I was supposed to be awake and participating in my government, and, you know, actively seeking a better world and doing more with myself than being a signpost, right? I could have been one of these things first. I wasn't. I made different choices. We all have. We've all made different choices. And what we need to do right now, and Bernie said this in the broadcast, he said, a lot of you, including me, you know, Bernie, you're talking to me. Bernie talks to me when he says this now, and I'm so glad he's saying this. He says, I know a lot of you are in despair, and you want to just throw your hands in the air and just give up, and it's like, fuck this shit. Bernie doesn't say that. But this is the time now, with everything crumbling, with everything collapsing around us, with our government at the top, at its weakest, this is the time to rise and fight. So don't worry about what you could have been first. Worry about what you are right now. Because we have an opportunity to change this whole planet and make it a better place for all of us. We'll see you guys in an hour or so. Thank you, Laura and Dennis and Markus, for being here. And thank you, family.
Pleasure.
Happy to be there.
Thank you, everybody.
See you guys. Bye-bye.
All right. See you in a little while, and we'll see you tomorrow for either another broadcast of we got the new show, the Pseudo-Intellectuals, coming up at 7. All right. Join us for that, and we'll probably try to find a rally in the morning. Peace, everybody.
Could have been a sailor, could have been a cook, a real life lover, could have been a book. I could have been a signpost, could have been a clock, as simple as a kettle, steady as a rock. Could be here and now. I would be, I should be, but how? I could have been one of these things first. I could have been. Could have stayed beside you, could have stayed for more. I could have been your statue, could have been your friend. A whole long lifetime could have been the end. I could be oh so true. I should be through and through. I could have been one of these things first. I could have been one of these things first. Thank you. up in a whistle, caught up in a float. A real life giver, caught up in a boat. I could have been a signpost, could have been a clock. As simple as a gutter, steady as a rock. I could be